So I work for Department of Employment and Economic Development, and we go to a lot of events in the community, veterans appreciation events, things like that, which he put on. It was amazing. There was 20 different community partners there, St. Cloud VA, St. Cloud Stand Down, there's the VFW, a very well-organized event. They had over 300 people come in, 100 different veterans, along with 200 family members, so really well put on event.
We came up with an idea of having a Veterans Day appreciation event. We ended up with that first event in 2018, that November. We had about 320 veterans and families show up. We had a beautiful dinner set up in the sanctuary, in the main auditorium of the church. We had a huge opening ceremony, color guard, national anthem, everything. Just an awesome ceremony that was put together, and it wouldn't have been done without all the awesome volunteers that we had from the church. Because as soon as they started hearing about it, we started just getting people we didn't know from the church saying, "Raul, we want to help." I'm not gonna lie, I was very proud. You know, I'm not a prideful person. I don't take a lot of light to myself. You know, I like staying away and just doing things in the background and making sure everybody else is taken care of. After that first event, our pastor and the staff, they were like, "We got to do this again." So. Last year we did our second event. The first year we had about 7 community partners show up. This last year we had about 22 community partners, and everything ranging from mental health to job, you know, employment agencies, and just everything in between.
So the spouses, kids, they don't get the recognition as much, and I think that's the one thing that really stood out, is when he was recognizing his wife and then the different spouses and then the kids. I think that was a big thing. But you don't see events like that too much.
This last year's Veterans Day Appreciation event, we put a little twist to it. Instead of the veterans always getting the thank you for your service, it was the veterans saying thank you to our spouses and our kids for basically putting up with us all these years. It makes me feel great, you know, to be able to give my wife some recognition. You know, my wife is my hero. She's the one that, again, like I said, she supports me, she encourages me. Veterans are our passion, but the kids and the families are our priority, because if the veteran's family is taken care of and they're cared for and they're in good health, chances are the veteran's going to be in good health.
I would say Raul is a hero in our community, Sartell, St. Cloud area. Absolutely, because he's out there trying to help any veteran he can. Any soldier that's currently in, seeing what he can do to help them out and improve their lives.
The effects of being in the service will continue on for a lifetime. If there's care involved, then it's gonna be a good experience. If it's neglected, then it might not turn out so well. You know, we're a life group that's just trying to provide that spiritual aspect and spiritual side of or support for our veteran community.